Alright. I want to talk about the Brigs Meyers Personality Test. So, where to begin? I guess you got 16 parts, right? You got 4 digits that you can. You got 8 digits. You got 8 letters, 4 in each column. So you can pick 4 out of 8. And that'll give you 16 variations. Isn't that pretty much how it works? Anyway, 16 personality types. So, if you think of it like a car, maybe, or a library, or a kitchen, or whatever, you got 16 parts. Basically, it's your brain, how it takes in information and how it perceives the information and works with the information and uses it. And, right? So you chuck up your brain in 16 parts, right? Well, 8 parts. 8 parts. And then there are 4 of those parts that you're going to emphasize. Because I guess the brain is just a network of neurons and whatnot, and electrical impulses. So they'll choose 4 main roads. Right? That's what you got. And that's pretty much it. You got 4 big boxes, and then you got 4 small boxes. Four compartments, and in those compartments you gotta set off a little section for the things that you're not good at. Like me, I'm an introvert, but I got a small section for being extroverted too. Which is long-term thinking. Right, then there's the S, you know, the little section for that, so I can think of, you know, instant gratification. And then there's the T, which is logical thinking. And then there's a little box for the F for me, which is emotions, which is just have emotions, it's just that I don't use them when I think. I just, you know, I don't react to them. I notice them and I just pass right by. And then there's P. So, yeah, I just perceive my environment and try to see everything in the environment and make my conclusions based on that. Then there's a tiny little space for J, which is, you know, judging. So if there's something in the environment I don't want to focus on, I'll just slide that off to the side. That's pretty much it. So, if you think of it like an engine, you got the electrical parts, right? And a small part of that is the rotor, right? So if the rotor is a little bit off, well, you're not going to work as well getting the ignition, you know, at the right time, but it'll still run. But it's not that consequential, really. So in a society, we need all 16 personality types. It's just that we don't get along. You know, extroverts don't understand introverts. And logical thinkers don't understand the feelingers, and the feelers don't understand the logical. And, you know, judging and perceiving. Use their words, you know, not like me. So that's the exact opposite of me. And they're gonna go for the instant gratification based on what they feel that they wanna do. And they're gonna lay down judgment on anything that contradicts it. Plain and easy. The opposite. Right. I think in my head, I focus on the end result. How do we get there? Talk a little bit more about that. I go the logical route. So it's just. It's based off of the basics, basically. I work off of the ground platform every time. And then, you know, I'm open to suggestions, inputs, a little bit loofy, I guess. As concrete, which is kind of funny because I'm working on the base level there, but the end, that is thinking long term, right. Now I got the T too, and that is basically you work off of the foundation, you start with the beginning, and you work your way through. F is more like, you gotta, this is what I want, how do I get there, and just somehow, just pick a route, you know, that's how I see it, more or less. And of course, it's not all straight on, man. I just, you know, watched a couple of YouTube videos, so I don't have any education or anything. But, self-taught, I guess. That's basically it. You know, sections of the brain. It's not literally that how it works, but figuratively. Like, let's say the mainstream is the, you know, center there, and then you have the small boxes on the sides, which are not often used. Yeah. can see it that way. I guess for me, it would start at the back, thinking introverted, right? But let's say it starts in the back, right? Now, an extroverted, you would just loop that to the front, wouldn't it? Just comes out in the mouth. Right? And then loops it back. Thinks about it. Right. It's fascinating how they intertwine with each other. Because I am an INTP, and I would say that's the far end. Scale and the SFJ is the other side of it. But it might be that the INTJ is the far end. Sit in silence, you think about what the end result is going to be, and then you take the logical route to figure it out, and you're always open to new suggestions, right? Extroverted is just go for it, you just talk, you want the instant gratification, and you do whatever you feel. You don't take too much input. If you're gonna input anything to a J, you're gonna have to talk a lot, convince them. So, yeah, I think it's the far end of the scale. I don't know. Yeah. Any thoughts? I'm a P, I'm open to suggestions. It is interesting. I just thought I'd make a little video on how to think about it. How to visualize how it works. Alright, so you start at the back. You got a box on each side, which has a smaller box on the outside. So you got four in the back there. Through, depending on what personality type you are, right? So you got four boxes, right? The one you use and the one that's attached to that, and I'm waving my hands here, right? And then there's the other side, which you don't really go into, right? If you split it down the middle, and then that has a smaller box which you really don't go into, right? And then you pick another box down, you know, further front. And then you pick a box there, and there's a smaller box attached to that, and maybe you'll jump into the other box just for the hell of it, you know. That's kind of a visual. When you check through all the boxes, you've made up your mind. Right. And if anybody says anything, you gotta go back in your boxes. Screw around. Yeah. Well, that's 15 minutes. More than enough, just a rant, right? So, thanks for watching. If you want something, please like it.